Learning and participation work at the Royal Opera House for two reasons. One is that a lot of people don't know much about our art forms of opera and ballet, so we do a lot of work where we're introducing people to what opera and ballet are. And the second thing is that we don't just sort of talk to them about it, we get them involved as participants, so we get them singing, dancing. The reason we're running this event today is to sort of open up, we hope, people's understanding of the range of careers that you can actually do working in the arts, because people tend to only think about, you know, being an actor or a singer or whatever it is. And in a place like the Royal Opera House, there are many more people working in behind-the-scenes departments than there are actually performing on the stage. And that ranges from technical things like stage management, lighting, sound, through to what I call the craft skills, like prop making, costume making. So we hope young people go away thinking, God, I didn't even know you could do that for a living. And maybe, you know, a few people go away thinking, I'm quite interested in doing that myself.
My role here in the Opera House is to program and operate the lighting control desk, which operates every single light in the Opera House that's pointing on the stage, so we can set up different scenes, different looks, different colours, and we work with a lighting designer to create the looks of the show, and we sit there, we program it all, and then during the performances we operate it when we're given our cues from the stage manager.
Because our school gave us the opportunity to come here, and I'm someone that takes like performing arts. At school we call it musical theatre, and I enjoy doing dance, acting and singing, so I see this as like an eye opener to like what I want to go into, and yeah.